Hi, today we are going to learn and I'm going to show you what is the basic difference between Git fork and Git clone, and I will go very basic step by step so you have a complete clarity on this. To start with, both Git clone and Git fork creates a copy of the repository or the project. So both of these creates copy of the project or the repository. The basic difference is when you do fork, it creates a copy on the remote or your server. For example, if you are working on github.com and you fork a repository, it will create a copy on the github.com or the remote. And when you do clone, it will create a copy on your local system or your local laptop or computer, wherever you are working. So this is the basic difference. Now let me show you. If I go to github.com, this is my github.com, my account, and if I go to any of the projects, let me go to this Selenium Java framework here, and here you can see it says fork 11. So that means 11 people have forked this repository or created a copy of this repository. And if I go here, it says you cannot fork this because this is my own repository, so I cannot create a fork or create a copy, a remote copy of my own repository. I can do a fork of another's, somebody else's public repository. So let us say I go to this new account. This is my another account on GitHub, and this is Raghav Pal Labs. Suppose I want to create a copy of this repository. This is a public repository, so I want to fork this here. So I will just search for it, and here let me say I will search here, and yes, I have got this. So you can see this is from Raghav Pal. This is the repository. I will go here, and now I will create a fork from here. So now I can create a fork of this repository, and you will see this repository is now copied into my current account, which is Raghav Pal Labs here. So I have created a fork or created a copy of this repository now here. Now the other thing is, now if I want to clone, I can go here and I can clone, and this will create a copy on my local system wherever I am working. So this is the first basic difference. Now the other thing is, when we commit the changes from our local to remote, we do a push. However, if I want to make any changes to this forked repository and I want this to merge in the original repository as a contributor, then I will have to create a pull request. Let me show you that as well. So here I will make some changes. I will say I will create a new file, and I will name this file mydemo.txt, and I will say this is a demo file, and I will just commit the changes. I will say created a demo file, and now I have two options here: commit directly to the master branch or create a new branch for this commit and start a pull request. As of now, I will just commit these changes. So I will commit, and now if I want this change to get merged in the original repository, I will have to create a pull request for the original owner of this repository. So I will go here, pull request, and now here I will create a new pull request from here, and here this is the change. You can see this is what I created. I will just say create pull request, and for this change I will create a pull request. Now the original author or the original repository will get this pull request, and then he or she can approve my changes and merge the changes. So if I go to the original repository, which is this one, and here you can see I have got one pull request. I will go here and I will see this is the open pull request created mydemo.txt. I can go here and see all the changes. So you can see I can see all the changes which were done, and then I can review. So as of now, no reviewers are added. Let me add myself as a reviewer first. So I'm adding myself as a reviewer, and now if I go back to the pull requests and I will go to this new change, you can now see I can now review the changes. I will go here, I will say add your review, and I will say review changes. I can give my comment and then I can approve or I can request changes. So this is the basic difference between fork and clone, and I hope now you understand what is forking and what is cloning. I will see you in the next episode of Ask Raghav. Thank you for watching.